The Carioca Arena in Rio de Janeiro's Olympic Park is the venue for the men's basketball quarterfinal game between Croatia and Serbia. Two Balkan rivals going head-to-head for a place in the men's basketball semi-final. Croatia have done it before. They made it to silver medal in 1992. This is new ground for Serbia, whose previous Olympics appearance in 2004, they finished 11th. Both have done well to get through very difficult groups. Croatia picking up 3 wins, Serbia with 2. However, they did push the United States to within 3 points of overtime. These are two well-balanced, strong teams with young players coming through. Both have very young sides, and they are rising in the basketball ranks. One place left in the semi-finals for Croatia and Serbia. It has been a titanic struggle so far in the men's basketball, and we're set for a titanic encounter here between two Balkan rivals. The Croatian team and the Serbian team have met before at the World Championships. In the last major meeting between the two in 2010, Serbia only won that one by a point. And they've done well here, and they're led by Milos Teodosic, their captain, and a real star performer. But there's a number of stars in this team.
There are. It's a real battle between the two Bogdanovics in this particular matchup. Serbia's Bogdanović is the shooting guard. He's number 7. He's one to be looking for. He's sitting second at the moment with the averaging of 13.4 points per game. And then Radulica as well, number 13, 17.6 officially, is the one to be looking for as far as overall offensive output from this Serbian side. And it'll be rugged, it'll be emotional, but at this point of the tournament, they must be disciplined, they've got to be smart, and they just have the opportunity here, a one-off crack at it, to move forward and to get into that semifinal. It's the last position that we're waiting to fill.
Croatia are ranked number 12, Serbia ranked number 6, but this Croatian team has been growing in the last few years. They haven't done too well in their previous results. 9th at the Eurobasket, 10th at the World Cup. But here, they have shown their quality, and there's some quality players in this team.
They've got depth as well. They've got a little smattering of a NBA influence. They've got a couple players. Number 9, Dario Saric, it plays with the Philadelphia 76ers, and the one to be looking for, currently applying his trade with the Brooklyn Nets in the NBA. And it is the other Bogdanović in this matchup for Croatia. Number 44, he's their shooting guard. He's the last one to be introduced. And there you see, as he comes forward across the line, he is the guy to really look for. And he, you talk about a player that's putting up the numbers. What an outstanding tournament he's had. 24.8 is his average points per game. And he's able to shoot and make it happen. And everything's going to run through him for the Croatians in this matchup.
Drazan Petrovic, the Croatian coach. We're now going to have the national anthems of Croatia and Serbia. The silver medalists of Barcelona 1992, Croatia, haven't been to a semi-final since they made the quarterfinals in 2008. Serbia have never been to this stage as Serbia. But of course, these two teams form part of the great Yugoslavian sides of the 1960s, 70s and 80s, and they are now bitter rivals. It's going to be a really tense game.
Of course, it's a huge element, a part of it, without a doubt. And you see, as we talk about the two different teams with the Bogdanoviches, it's Bojan Bogdanović, who is the player for Croatia. And then really close to name, it's Bogdan Bogdanović, who's number seven for the Serbians. You talk about, obviously, close proximity. This is the Croatian lineup as we look at it. And the story as well of Petrovic, their coach, and that one of... well, familiarity for a lot of basketball fans as well, that name in the sport. But this particular region produces great athletes across a number of sports, and this one particularly growing in strength. There you see the coach, Aleksandar Petrovic.
He was the brother of Drazan Petrovic, who tragically died in a car accident in Germany, a former Croatian great. And what a special moment it is for him, meeting a team, a nation that they used to play with when they were growing up, the players of that generation. But it's all about Croatia at the moment for this side. They do have some real talent in their team, as does the Serbian side. Milos Teodosic has been a fantastic captain for them. But their top scorer is Miroslav Radulica, the big man.
He's a big man. He'll be a presence. They'll need to feed him and get him involved early in this game. And it's often a big part of opening up the shooting game on the perimeter by getting the big man involved and just making sure that you've got to respect him. And Saša Djordjević is the man involved. He is the leader of this side. He's got them primed and ready. This is the last matchup of the quarterfinals, and getting late in Rio for this one, but these have to be sharp and focused and attentive to all the small areas of the game that are going to be differential in this.
Did a great tactical job, the Serbian coach, against the United States, where they played them so well and pushed them. For Croatia, there's been mixed results. It started well against Spain, then they lost to Argentina. The surprise defeat to Nigeria, but what a comeback. The game they needed to win against Lithuania, and they won by 9.
And it's a game that, as you say, needed to win to get forward in the group. And the top four teams coming through into those quarterfinals, and then the Serbians with a couple victories. They start off well against Venezuela, but then three subsequent losses to Australia, France, and then the United States of America, and then a victory, a very impressive one, by the impressive 34-point margin over China. And there is the starting lineup for Croatia, and Bogdanović is a shooting guard, 44, and Ukić as well, the point guard, will really mastercraft or architect this offense for their side. Ball runs through him as well. They'll want to move it quickly and, of course, get themselves activated as shooters.
Milos Teodosic is the leader for Serbia on the court as well as off it, but they also have the big man, Miroslav Radulica, who is 7 foot tall, 213 centimeters. The referee, Juan Carlos Garcia from Spain, Boris Rijic, and Roberto Vasquez, the umpires from Ukraine and Puerto Rico, respectively. A big encounter for these two. They've met in international friendlies in recent years, but not since 2010 have they met in a major tournament. Serbia were the winners on that occasion. You think that the performance against the United States will give them confidence they can match it with anyone?
Of course, and you know, the Americans are well regarded as a top leading nation in the sport of basketball. We've seen actually the commissioner of the National Basketball Association in attendance in the facility here today, and you just see the international flavor growing in this one. This is a real local rivalry in the Balkan region of Europe, where these two sides have an opportunity to impress with just how capable and how well developed that sport of basketball has come in that region.
Number 6 team in the world, Serbia, against the number 12 team, Croatia, for a spot in the Olympic Games semi-final. It's Croatia against Serbia in the men's basketball quarterfinal. Serbia with the first possession and the first points. A dunk for the Serbian side. Brilliant stuff to start from Nikola Kalinic.
And Kalinic just takes that quick feed. It's a low one. He's got to take it in stride. And you almost get a sense that was a set play, but that was a little bit of a broken play that they make the most of, Serbia. And they'll be well impressed to have taken that in full flow and then a two-handed jam to get things rolling.
Serbia sending a message early. Simon trying to send one back, and Bilan in under the basket. The big man working for Croatia.
good option. Get to the inside, work this defense, and just bank it in. Get that scoreboard activated. Get your big man involved.
Markovic giving it to Radulica. The foul spotted. Officials have been very strict on any contact anywhere on the court, really. Here's that previous play from great pass from Ted Dosic.
It's outstanding. It's outstanding to get the rise into a position for him to take it and to put it home, but the response equally coming back from the Croatians, and both sides want to make sure that they keep this game tight. Don't allow it to get away from either of the sides, and that would be entirely just the game plan. We've got a fallen player here taken down.
You can already tell the feeling between these two. Teo Dosic was yelling at the referee that this was his ball. Not sure who that came off, really. That's so hard to judge. I think it went Croatia's way. Indeed, it did. And already a physical encounter.
Well, he's back. He's up and involved. And we're still inside the opening minutes of this game.
Offensively, Serbia was so good against the United States. They're putting the pressure on here against Croatia. Ukic giving it to Sadic, one of the NBA stars, future NBA stars for the Croatian side. Simon with Sadic, who's important for the Croatian side. He's being fouled there by Matvan of Serbia. Sadic, the top scorers in the Croatian side. 12.8 points a game. He is the top scorer along, aside from Bojan Bogdanovic. He's inbounding here for Bilan, well outside his normal operating area of the paint. Ukic back with Bilan, shooting for two, well short. Picked up by Teodosic now, driving, pulling up for the jump shot. Teodosic, it doesn't drop for him, so both teams with early baskets dropping off here.
A little bit scrappy so far. This is a great advancing play, and they come right back. The Croatians in style. There's Bilan, the big man, takes that feed in motion and drops it down with the quick flush. And that's another answer to the opening score from the Serbians. They've taken the lead.
They are up by two now as another foul is called. You think the officials just want to stamp their authority on this game and say, this is it. This is what you're not allowed to do. But Bilan was allowed to dunk it there in over Radulica. The two big men, what a battle they're going to have. They're both the same height, 7 foot.
Well, and particularly when they get elevated and up off that floor, it can become dangerous, particularly if you're expecting contact. But he stays strong and is balanced enough to make sure he completes the play. And again, the referee's right on it and just say, keeping a close eye and making sure that this game isn't going to get sloppy or get into something beyond what's actually just happening here in the confines of this basketball game.
Yeah, Dosic was the player foul. He was a bit annoyed that the basket didn't count. It's going to be a sideline inbound for Serbia. Here is Teo Dosic. He's a real worker, a really smart basketball player. Good passer of the ball as well. Markovic to Radulica. The shot clock's down to five. Turnaround jump shot. Doesn't drop for him. And a strong offensive rebounding by Serbia there. They'll get another shot here. Clock reset to 14 seconds. Great pass from Teo Dosic. He loves that bounce pass after the run is made, and Sadic down here. I think it's going to be a Serbia ball. It's trying to get the hook shot over Sadic. Some contact there.
He's going to feel it when the big man comes in. He was in motion. Nice little jump hook there. He tries to just find the angle, but it's mostly Sadic who feels the brunt of that action.
Radulica at the low post, where he likes to operate, but he's given this one back, and the three-point attempt is missed. So, bit off the shooting from Serbia early on. Matvan with the triple attempt was unsuccessful. They've only got the first basket of the game. It's a close one early.
It's interesting just watching the ball as it does hit the rim. It seems a little bit of a softer rim as far as the ability for the ball maybe to be captured and easily fall through the basket. We've seen that a couple times. Seen the American Kevin Durant and him shooting from the outside. Seems to have a number of times rattled around uncharacteristically that you might not normally see and still fall into the hoop.
Croatia with no more fouls to give in this quarter. Bogdanovic for three. He misses his first attempt. The Brooklyn Nets star, the star of this Croatian team. Here comes Serbia now in response. Markovic getting it back in there for Radulica. What strength shown. Can't finish it off. What good offensive rebound. Matvan.
It's outstanding from Radulica to come in. He's within three, four players, and he outmuscles him again. He comes over the back, a little too aggressive. He gets caught up with the good success he had there a moment ago. and just watching the referees here and how they're going to mark this particular play. But it's an important part of the battle between the big men, and he's being aggressive early.
Tried to just get that one to come off Billung and out of bounds, but I think he committed a foul in trying to do so. Oh no, the foul is actually on Croatia. So Radulica is at the line for two here. Must have been before when the shot was made. That's why he's at the line. Not the greatest three-throw shooter, Radulica, although he has got 70% from the foul line, so not bad for a big man. One from two here, and it's a one-point game in the opening 3 minutes between Croatia and Serbia. Lots of fouls already. Here's Bukic for Croatia, the captain, the organizer from backcourt, Sadic. This is what he does so well, but he's off target. Both of the big players off target early on.
He backs his man in well for that little jump hook. Just can't make it count. Both sides just trying to get some consistency. Look at this war inside. And again, we're seeing it happening. We're really almost being smothered, but the referee's happy to let it play on.
Interesting, considering what they were calling early, and they call that. The reach-in is very strict. Any time a player tries to reach in to touch the ball, it's unless they get it completely cleanly, it's a foul.
There you see the field goals already. 1 from 10, the opportunities that have been taken. And the Serbians trying to make it count. They're being the more aggressive, but again, it's just about getting conversion from your opportunities.
Bogdanovic, great outside shooter, but working in the middle here, and the ball doesn't drop for him. He will get the foul, however, and goes to the line for two. Even though we've only had less than 4 minutes of play, the foul count is now, with both teams, have none to give. Every foul now will be two shots at the basket.
Yeah, it hasn't been smooth so far for either side. We had that quick opening play, and since then it has really been a little bit fraught, and neither team looking particularly polished. They're certainly engaged. They certainly are wanting to make the most of their plays, but just need to settle into this game and start letting their basketball do the talking. Here's Bogdanovic in a great position to add to his average point scoring in this tournament, over 24 points a game, and he does make them count at the line there, further assisting this Croatian advantage.
3-point lead now for Croatia. Nikola Kalinic will get a rest. Two personal fouls for him. Bogdanovic 77% from the line in the tournament, but it's 100% there. Two. Here's Teodosic out now to Markovic. Going to find the gap, but closed down by the Croatian defense. Mačvan for three. It's the first triple for Serbia, and Mačvan knocks it down.
He was given space and time. He gets a direct look there from the top of the key, and he just strokes it. And there, within a shot, it's back to level.
Sadic for Croatia. From the top of the key, Dario Sadic is off the mark. And that's important for Croatia. Sometimes he takes a while to get going, but when he does, he's very good.
Well, it rattled around inside that rim, but it had enough of the inside of it in which to fall. But he's seeing that again. It's watching the movement of the ball as it comes off. We almost had it see it stuck in beside the rim in the backboard prior, but now they are starting to feel the stroke there. And this just a little bit of a half indecision to whether to slam it or whether to lay it on and do the finger roll, and it doesn't drop.
Uncharacteristic error from Bogdanovic after the turnover from Croatia, their defensive pressure created, but they need to finish those off in what's going to be a tight game. Radulica has done well so far, hasn't got the points, but you feel it might be coming.
Well, he's had a presence in this ball game already. He's certainly alerted the Croatians as to what he's going to be bringing to the party in this game.
Here's Markovic driving through the lane and getting it in off the board. Great stuff from Serbia there. They're 8-all now.
Just taking a lane, isn't it? Seeing an opening, and they did that immediately. There's a little bit of a flicker again of what we have seen, what they're capable of doing, just attacking that basket.
Simon for three, long range attempt. It is a shorter arc in the international game than the NBA, but off target there. Teodosic for Mačvan. Don't mind the patient approach, Serbia, waiting, playing the extra pass, looking for the open player. Markovic, Mačvan has plenty of time here and knocks down another three.
Well, he's very comfortable from there. That's his second in the last minute. And you're just seeing a player just getting comfortable and settling into his game, and he's dropped him back-to-back three-pointers.
Serbia seem to be settling in now after missing a few shots early on. Is Bogdanovic trying to get things going for Croatia. Oh, and it's stolen. Brilliant defensive play from Serbia. I think it may have been Teodosic who got the steal there. Such a smart player, Teodosic. Inside with the pass, and it's finished off eventually by Jokic for Serbia.
Smart work, aggressive movement from the Serbians to attack the basket. Croatia just looking a little bit split as to their assignments, as to who they were going to be marking. And that quick ball movement and then the quick bounce pass inside is finished off with the, well, the partial dunk. At the end of the day, the most important thing, it's in the basket and it's points on the board for Serbia. They now take a 5-point advantage.
Just thought there might have been a timeout call, but Petrovic was saying, no, just a substitution. And it's Hezonja on, their 3-point specialist for Croatia. Need to improve on the outside shooting, they might think. Here's Bogdanovic. Nowhere for him to go. Back to Hezonja. Inside is Bilan. Quick pass out to Babic, who's on for Croatia as well at the low post. Bilan. And he's missed the hook shot. So it started well for Bilan, but he's missed a few shots now.
It's Saric there as well. He's a big part of this machine, and he's just been a little bit stalled so far in getting himself activated at that offensive side of the floor.
Markovic taking his time. It's Bojan Bogdanovic for Serbia, who's missed the attempted three. But the whistle's gone. The foul on Jokic inside. Trying desperately to get to the rebound. It's a 5-point lead for Serbia with 3:30 left in this first turn. Great pass from Teodosic again.
And Serbia as a team overall in this tournament have a 5-point greater average scoring per game than do the Croatians. So not to expect that that's going to be the determination of the result tonight, but they have had greater scoring overall in the games they've played.
Serbia in that team foul situation, which means that that foul was two shots at the line for Miro Bilan. He's knocked down the first. The tallest player on the court, along with Miroslav Radulica, both 213 centimeters or 7 foot. And he's knocked down both free throws there. Croatia back to within three.
So important to take advantage of your free throws. You've got to put those bonus points on the board, and Croatia just pegging it back with those couple shots.
There's Jokic for Serbia, taking on Bilan. That's a desperate attempt at a shot. There was no way that was going in.
Well, he almost thought he had a half step on his man driving and just drop stepping to the basket. This is a long extended finger roll that never gets an opportunity to really have a chance to go in, but then you see the crashing of the Croatians responding to it and then falling out. The Serbians will keep the opportunity in which to maintain this offensive control. They've given it up and they've called it as a foul on the play, pushing the Croatian player, and it's led to shots immediately to the other end.
This is the trouble for both these teams now, because they fouled so often early. Every foul now is going to be two shots at the basket. However, Babic hasn't taken advantage with his first attempt. Actually, somewhat surprisingly, his first attempt in the whole tournament. He's got his first free throw of the whole tournament. Luka Babic there getting the point for Croatia. 2-point game now. Markovic for Serbia. Teodosic off, that's going to go into backcourt. It's a backcourt violation. Serbia saying it was touched by a Croatian player, but the referees didn't see it that way.
The refs are right on it, and obviously that over and back and the frustration from the players, but they're never going to win an argument with the officials and just need to keep to the task at hand.
Hezonja to inbound for Croatia. Bilan is putting things going for the Croatian side. Expect to have a running battle with Radulica in the middle. This is Bojan Bogdanovic for Croatia, driving here under the hoop and gets the foul. And no, travel called, in fact. Well, he thought he got the basket there, but the travel is a bit different in international basketball than it is in the NBA.
He's just got 2 points so far in his matchup. He thinks he's got the defender committed, and he is just as curious about the call from the official. Thought he had done enough to get the hoop and the harm, and the referee saw it otherwise, and Serbia with a chance now to respond.
Bogdanovic may be used to more NBA officiating than international basketball. What defensive pressure here from Croatia, but Serbia found the open player. The 3-point shot is missed, however, by Matvan. hit back-to-back threes earlier, and Babic, he loves to drive through, get things going, and it's going to be a Serbia ball coming off Babic last.
Well, he shows his speed and his range, maybe just a little bit uncontrolled coming up to the middle of the court. There was enough of the Serbians back in support to make that a challenge to be able to take that right to the basket, and it's really an easy turnover and a possession again for Serbia.
Yeah, Dosic back on with a couple of minutes left in this first quarter. Still a lead for Serbia. Bogdanovic back with Matrvan now. Bogdanovic. And they tried the extra pass. It's what they like to do. Work the ball around, move around. It hasn't come off for them there.
Matrvan almost looked as though he's going to pull up and take the jumper. He stroked those two back-to-back three-pointers, and you expected that maybe he would go to it again, but he looks to use the passing play. They will have the opportunity, though, on the inbound.
Radulica coming back on for the last couple of minutes, going to renew that battle with Milan. But two threes for Milan Matrvan. Good contribution from him. Points off the bench being very important for Serbia. 45 on average. That's more than double what Croatia have achieved so far. Jovic for Serbia. Now this is Bogdanovic, the Bogdanovic in this game, who's got in the shot eventually off the rim. And it's a four-point lead for Serbia.
And a good presence just to come back and onto the floor and get the scoreboard ticking over again for the Serbians.
There's Dario Sadic. Yet to really get going in this game, showing glimpses of what he's capable of. Same with Bojan Bogdanovic. Sadic, foul called on Radulica. That's that battle with Planinic now, the player deputizing for Bilan. The earlier shot from Bogdanovic in off the rim.
You just see how flexible the rim is in this international tournament, and you wouldn't see that necessarily so much at the NBA level, but it's just interesting how favorable it has allowed the ball to roll and maybe get some advantage to the shooting.
Planinic at the line for two again. This is the seventh team foul conceded by Serbia. In fact, it's only the first for Radulica, maybe surprising for him. You might even look at that and think that was a surprise, but Planinic knocks down the first attempt. He's been at 77% from the foul line. Two from two here.
And simple stuff, you must take advantage of that free throwing, and they do. They are back within that one basket again. They've been kind of trailing this game so far, haven't they, the Croatians? Haven't had a chance really to take control of it much themselves. It's been aggressive, driving the basket again, and Serbia, an outstanding feed and a finish to the big man. He will take it and put it home, Radulica. And that's outstanding work from Serbia. Just a moment for two players to capitalize on some weak defensive play from Croatia.
Dosic has three of those five assists for Serbia. Sadic from the top of the key. He's missed it, but what an offensive rebound. It's fallen straight to Simonovic, however. Here's Teodosic, who's really worked the court brilliantly. Just waiting for the moment, giving the right pass away. Exchanging passes here with Jovic and gives it back to him. Oh, brilliant stuff here from Serbia. Just missed the finish. Incredible stuff. Croatia on the fast break. They got a 3-on-2. Out to Bogdanovic for three. And they've punished that missed attempt by Serbia with a triple.
What a momentum shifter at one end, and you see it so often in sport when you don't execute, you leave the opening, you almost really inspire the opposition to try to take advantage, and they do fully. Croatia, outstanding finish, and then a response right back to Serbians, and now all of a sudden the level of the game has gone up a little bit. Jokic with the long-range shot, and they reestablish the margin.
Brilliant stuff from Jokic in response, restoring the four-point lead for Serbia. Game clock and shot clock in sync now. This could be the last chance to score before the end of the first quarter, and might be a foot violation. That's going to be a Croatia ball, in fact.
And they will get the opportunity to inbound. There is their threat, looking to see him, Bogdanovic from outside, and he just gets the touch.
And it's a buzzer beater for Croatia. Bojan Bogdanovic. What a confidence booster that is. They've reduced the deficit from 4-1. And the final shot of the first quarter, Bogdanovic with the long-range three.
It took him a little bit of time to get heated up, but he is now stroking it for Croatia. And this has just brought it within the 1 point. There you see the illumination of the backboard. Time had fully expired in the first quarter. And now he is rolling.
Serbia have worked hard in that first quarter. They looked good. But at quarter time, it's Croatia 19, Serbia 20. The shooting so far has been not the best from both teams, but the three-point shooting, quite impressive. It's quite even on the scoreboard in front. Second quarter underway, and it's a mistake there from Croatia. Quite an inexplicable one. Sadic took the ball and went straight into backcourt.
Now they inbounded it. They were already in the offensive half and then moved it back, and just maybe losing their bearings and just being a little bit absent-minded to start this second quarter of play.
It wasn't even a second on the clock when that happened. It's Serbia possession. It should have been Croatia's, really. Radulica at the low post, taking on Planinic. He cannot finish, though. He's getting the better of his man, just not applying the finish.
It's just coming in. He's just not getting enough touch to get it as an angle off the backboard. He's almost just coming, because of his height at 7 feet, he's just trying to slide it across into the rim rather than shooting it off the backboard and making it simple.
Bogdanovic, who ended the first quarter with a buzzer beater. He is the go-to player for Croatia. Doesn't drop for him off the board. So unlucky. Used the angle well there.
He did, and it really kicked off the rim there. Pretty strong, in fairness, and it's just interesting to see just the true nature of the rim and just whether the players have a good sense for it.
Bogdanovic to inbound. Well, this one only slightly better for Croatia, but look at the pressure coming from the Serbian defense. Babic getting the screen from Planinic. And it's a challenge there on Planinic from the Serbian player, Stefan Jovic, on for the Serbian side. First personal foul for him, the first team foul of this quarter. They really are ratcheted up for Serbia in the last term. Lukic back on, the Croatian captain. Here's Bogdanovic. Again, pressure coming, that half-court pressure, trying to stop the outside shooting for Croatia. Bogdanovic kicks it out to Lukic, drives instead, and just drives straight into Radulica, who fouled him.
And Radulica got to be careful with the fouls that he's taken already in this match. It's good to be aggressive, but he's going to have to keep his discipline in check.
He actually fouled out in Croatia's last game against Lithuania. Always treading a very fine line, Miroslav Radulica. He's sent Lukic to the line here. Looking for the first points of this second quarter. And we're still looking because Lukic has missed the first attempt. This to try and level it up for Croatia. And the captain delivers. It's 20-all between Croatia and Serbia. It's really tense on both benches, and it's tense on the floor as well.
It started tight. It continues to be so in the second period. And the shooting from the Croatians picking up. They've had the advantage from the free throw line. Other than that, it's been very marginal. But again, it's an aggressive approach from Serbia, taking the ball to the basket. And right in the middle of again, is the big man. As he's down, he gets picked up, and he'll have the opportunity. Expect that they would award him with two shots there, but just waiting.
Might be an inbound. Wasn't going for the shot, determined the referee. That's why it's a Serbia inbound with 14 seconds on the shot clock. Teodosic with the ball. Out to Radulica. He's not going to take a three attempt. Does his best work in the paint. Jovic to Jokic. The shot clock's running down on Serbia. They have to get it away here. I'm not sure. Well, he has seen it, Jokic. Oh, he's done it! Oh, brilliant stuff. It looked like he just lost the shot clock there, but no, he knew it.
He did, just in time, the running jumper and off the backboard as well. What a finish and a follow through. It's just in time. You heard the horn from the shot clock going off.
Turnover. And Serbia coming forward here on the fast break, and he's fouled Bogdanovic by Lukic, just trying to stop the momentum there. It was stolen, I think, against Teodosic, providing the pressure. This is the earlier attempt on the buzzer from Jovic.
Well, it's an off-balance shot, and they are able to execute it. The big man will go off and take a breather as they set the look of this Serbian side, preparing for making sure to keep Radulica in this matchup, because he plays a rugged brand of basketball, but it's got to be a smart brand as well to help his side best.
Jovic We got the rebound, had a chance to go again, passed it off to Mačvan, and it's going to be a Croatia ball. Every ball that goes out is contested. Every official decision from the official is contested.
Well, it almost seems a little bit like it's... Well, as we say, there's a different emotional edge to this matchup, and it's not maybe as refined. You get a sense that this is a grudge match. It's personal, and equally, that's part of that flair where they're challenging things, and they've got to be careful, both teams, because they've got to keep it all about their productivity in the game.
Previously, great aggression and athleticism shown by Sadic. Great 360 turn by Jukic. Hezonja, who's a three-point specialist. Too strong there, not off the mark yet. He hasn't been getting many looks, but when he does, he's very strong indeed from outside shooting. Jovic. Mačvan on for Serbia again. Bogdanović. Jokic has plenty of time to measure the three. Pressure wasn't coming. He's missed it.
Quite a bit of flair here in the last minute or two. Just the 360s, the no looks, and the passing game. And then these popping it from three-point range shots and just needing to get their efficiency a little bit higher. Another one rattles off the rim and out, and just the get a sense that maybe the game's just being played a little bit of a faster pace, that both teams are comfortable.
The flare won't matter if the shots don't go in. Teodosic, who intends to make things matter for Serbia, particularly with his passing. He's gone for a long-range three here. But offensive rebound, they have dominated that area, Serbia. Down to 9-1, extraordinary statistic for them. Bogdanović driving straight through the lane. Brilliant stuff from Bogdanović for Serbia. Vladi Divac in attendance. Not sure he saw that one, but he'll be watching.
Well, it's just a great play to pick that ball up over the defender and just drive the basket and just finish the good work. And there now the Serbians back in front with the two-point advantage. And there a long-range shot. And is it going to be counted as a three from Bogdanović? He was in range. They will give him the benefit of it. He was behind the line. And he comes back to his bench on the timeout. And he's trying to pump up his Croatian team.
6:06 to play in the half. Croatia have hit the front. It's Croatia 25, Serbia 24. It's another tense, tight battle between two rival teams in the men's basketball quarterfinal. Croatia ahead by a point. 6 minutes to go in the half. It's been a seesawing contest. Croatia edging it at present. Bogdanović drove through the lane with his last possession. Thought about the three. Inside for Mačvan, that's better from Serbia. They're passing, the bounce passing inside is extraordinary.
It is, it's right on the mark, and so well executed for a second there. He thought they were going to elevate and take the shot, and then the defenders commit to it, and Bogdanović makes the feed inside, and Mačvan just was a real comfortable score.
Well, the finger roll for Mukic doesn't drop. Showing a lovely soft touch there, just didn't drop for him. And the foul is called here on Serbia, so it's going to be a Croatia ball.
This is the look at the play again, and just it's the positioning backing up into the defender, and the way the feet came in on that side of the body, the defender really had to just relinquish, and it's just a just an easy 2 points on the board for Serbia to come out of that timeout and to go back in front.
They are back in the lead by a point, the Serbian side, but it's been exchanging hands for the last few minutes. Bogdanović being pressured here by his opposing name. Bogdanović getting a bit of help. Bilan trying to get into the paint where he likes to operate. Again, it's a wild type of hook shot, almost from the side. Babic He drives, and it's straight into trouble, and the foul is called on Babic. It's going to be a Serbia ball.
And they'll take that loose ball. They contest for it, but a little bit sloppy, getting a hand in there, and it was a little bit of an odd sort of, rather than alley-oop, it was an under-loop, trying to get to the basket, and you've seen that a couple times from the big men who end up just rolling the ball across the back of the basket between the backboard and just haven't quite had the touch that they need to be more effective, obviously, with their scoring.
Ivanovic looking to get the screen. Nachvan on the outside. Now to Marković. The shot clock's running down on Serbia. Oh, that took the extra pass, and maybe the shot was required because it's a shot clock violation.
And they just lose a little bit of track of what was going on out there, and that's where you just get a sense sometimes. You saw the mistake on the inbound coming in on the second period, or the second quarter here, and you just start to see a few of these mental lapses even from both of these teams, that they are just needing to make sure they play within themselves. Bogdanović will have a sit down, and he is starting to really find his range in this match.
11 points so far for Bogdanović. Here's Daniel Sadic, their other top scorer and top performer. There's nothing more than to take players on, roll off them, and get it in off the board. And he's got a foul there, as Machvan is called.
He's been ever-present, has he, Machvan? This is the shot from Bogdanović, where he just steps out, gets beyond the outstretched hand of the Serbian defender, and you're starting to see him inspire his side. And if there's any real leadership that's definite in this game so far, it's growingly become obvious that Bogdanović is coming to the party. Need a little bit more from this man here at the free throw line. He also, with the experience with the Philadelphia 76ers in the NBA, and he's a youngster, but he equally is capable of being a difference maker in this match.
He has shone for Croatia, particularly in that game against Lithuania. He's missed his second free throw, and it's picked up by Serbia. Again, the rebounding they're very strong from. Nedovic on for Serbia, giving it to Bogdanović, kicking it out to back to Nedovic, who's missed the three-point attempt. Bilan out to Ukić. Got plenty of time to measure the three. Ukić, no pressure at all, sinks the three.
Well, they gave enough of a threat of the passing options that he had available to him, and all of these Serbian players trying to anticipate those passing lanes. He just pulls up, he takes the daylight, he takes the room available, looks around, sets, and takes his moment. And it's a massive three. As you see it falling, a beautiful shot, nothing but net.
Radak on the ball, but you just wonder, before Serbia were putting great pressure on the half, at the half court against Croatia, worried about those three-pointers. There was nothing there.
It's a soft pocket in the defense that he establishes for himself by giving enough looks to the teammates for on the Croatian rush there, and he just is able to create a seam and fully executes.
Timeout taken by Serbia. Serbia down by three. They were leading for so much of that first quarter. But here, against their arch rivals, Croatia, for a spot in the Olympic Games semi-final. They're behind by three after that triple from Ukić, who was completely open. They've given possession away again. And Croatia starting to assert themselves in this game. Luka Babic. Very deep screen, it looked like, from Bilan, doing everything he can to give his players some space. Ukić again. Going all the way through there, Ukić. Offensive rebound for Croatia. They've been rare. Second chance for them. Bilan to Babic. Oh, he's playing at a really high pace, Luka Babic. Now Ukić, another long-range three attempt. That one well wide of the mark. And a foul called, Serbia ball.
It's It's a strong possession for Croatia. Things going through. Ukic, he utilizes his teammates there. They see Saric wrapped up down low, trying to get to the basket. And unfortunately, really, rather wasteful. They don't get a chance to make, they get the offensive rebound as well. And that's the frustration. But Croatia are in the lead. Saric will sit down and take a breather.
Croatia now in that foul situation where every foul will be two shots at the basket for Serbia from the foul line. They cannot get it from the baseline there. That will not count from Radulica. The whistle had already gone. Another mistake from in close. They've made a number of those, Serbia.
Well, it was a double hop, wasn't it, in preparation. Needed to take that in continual motion, go and lay that in off the glass. And I think sensing that there was going to be contact from the Croatian defensive player, they almost got set and then took another little bunny hop to try to get up and off the glass. And by then, he had really lost his angle.
Bilan in the paint. That one does drop for him. And Croatia are out to a five-point lead now.
Smooth work from Bilan just to roll to the basket and take that from the left-handed side and make sure that it drops.
2:34 to play in this half. Bilan just getting it in over the outstretched Radulica. Not an easy thing to do.
He protects the ball well. He knew that he was going to get contact. He went up with two hands until he's fully extended as he releases it to the left side and just makes sure he's uncontested, gets that touch off the glass.
Roko Ukic can only make one more foul before fouling out as Teodosic is at the line, because that was Croatia's fifth foul of this quarter. One of the best shooters for Serbia. One of their star players. Makes wonderful assists. Those numbers are extraordinary. And they continue 100% from the line there.
Teodosic just marshalling this attack for Serbia, making sure that they've kept on point. And just, again, a good measured output from the line.
Bogdanović has gone into the paint unchecked there. He salutes the pass, which was fantastic. And Bogdanović has been informed so far in this one. A great move from Serbia. Again, they cannot finish it. Still, oh, it's taken away. Goaltending called, it looked close, but the 2 points given to Serbia.
Very active Serbia with this long pass coming down. It's not clean enough with their finishing, but they stay with it and get the benefit of the goaltending call. And they will be on 30 points, and just keeping this match tight, neither side can afford to let it slip much beyond that range. It's been as much as 5 points for Croatia in the lead.
Ahead by three here, shot clock's down to five. Bogdanović, the long range three, he knocks it down. Brilliant stuff from Bojan Bogdanović.
He's gone to another level, and he really is starting to show his class and his pedigree. Bogdanović from the inside there again, from the outside, where he's done the majority of his scoring in this matchup. And he's really proving himself an in and outside threat. He's got 16 points now as a result of that three-pointer.
Great numbers from Bojan Bogdanović. Teodosic replied with a two for Serbia. Definitely their star. Bilan running into trouble and charging foul called on Bilan. It's going to be a Serbia ball. 4 points in it. This is such a tight contest. 1:22 to play in the half.
Matchband just establishes. No, it's not Matchband, rather. Makovic. It's Makovic who gets into that position, establishes his position, and he's still, and he takes the offensive foul, and just smart defensive play, and he's seeing a little bit of frustration from Bilan there.
And that's with Croatia winning. I'd hate to see if they weren't. Here's Kalinic to Bogdanović, I should say. Bogdan playing for Croatia. Radulica back with Teodosic. Serbia are a patient team. They look for that important pass, but Radulica here is into trouble, and he cannot finish again. He's doing well. It's getting into position. Just not finishing it off.
Well, he's been in. He's made that traffic happen, or made those opportunities in traffic, and as you say, just not been clinical enough with the finish.
Turnover here. As Teodosic goes to the hoop. Oh, even he's not finishing. That's a real concern for Serbia. How did that stay out? 4 points in it. 40 seconds left in the half. We've got a real tight affair here between two well-matched teams. Two rivals in international basketball. The timeout is called. Bojan Bogdanović making it 3 points for Croatia, a 4-point lead for them.
Ako je ovdje za Bogdanovića hand off, okolo. Ovaj sa druge strane isto mora da pomogne odavde. Nema ništa. Ali morate pritiska loptu. Ne možemo trojica pritikamo da na dvojica stojimo. Mora se pritiska lopta, ej. Ej, pričam, to je taj pas.
Both coaches are quite animated on the sideline. There's a lot in this. It's not just semi-finals of the Olympic Games. There's bragging rights at stake as well. And Teja Tosic has led the way for Serbia.
Oh, just outstanding driving to the basket. He goes up with the right hand there, makes sure his stronger side. And you see the big man. He's so recognizable on the floor. And he just needs to be a little more settled, though, on the offensive glass, because now he's on the opposite side. Croatia, Bogdanovic is 4 from 5 from three-point range, and he's been able to just influence this scoreline so quickly. They've had to be a little bit more clinical, Serbia, if they really want to stay in this match, because plays like that will just really illustrate the fact that they've been a little bit sloppy and untidy sometimes, Serbia offensively.
Simon with the floater off the backboard. Don't see too many of those in international basketball. For NBA stars, it seems, I think.
It was a glorious finish. And again, we've seen a couple of running shots like that, just from the one-foot leaps, just trying to make the most of the possession before the shot clock expires.
Teja Tosic, the shot clock and the game clock running down on him. And that's going to be the last chance for Serbia and Croatia. It is halftime in what has been an absorbing contest. Croatia are edging it at present. Bojan Bogdanovic with 16 points at halftime. It's Croatia 38, Serbia 32.
To look back over the work so far in the match, a better shooting from the field, 46% Croatia, and that's starting to be reflected there as well. 2-point range, but from 3 points, that's Bogdanovic who's really been giving them benefit of that. Both sides at the 75% clip at the free throw,
led by 16 points from Bojan Bogdanovic, which included 4 threes. They're looking stronger at the moment, but this one could still go either way.
Of course, and Bogdanovic was a little bit slow starting at that in the first period, and then just really caught fire. It was those back-to-back three-pointers that just gave him the impetus to get activated, and he was really being relied upon to just get this team kick-started offensively, and then they started to flow. You saw the reaction from their coach at the end of that first half. Petrovic coming up and really just showing his delight and his excitement at how Bogdanovic has been so effective in a match that is emotional, personal, has underlying tones because of its history to it. This, the quarterfinals, the last one to go through. And, well, it's still all to play for, but the advantage for Croatia, who were just a little bit slicker in that first half.
Radulica, that's better from him. He got so many looks from that position, and this one, he's actually put away.
He looks more controlled. He came out with so strong and so energized. And he needs to play, yes, aggressive, but possibly a little too emotional in that first half of play.
So reduced the deficit to 4, but great passing move. Azonia, the three-point specialist with the dunk.
Oh, he just took it so clean and went right to the basket and just slams it down. And it was good, really, from Serbia not to get involved in that, because he let that ball just kick up off him and go out of play, and he was kind of puffing his chest out after such a convincing dunk.
Markovic for 3. Bouncing off the rim, picked up by Hezonja. It's a 6-point lead again for Croatia at the start of this third quarter. Led by 6 at halftime. Started to take control since the second quarter, but turnover there. Great little interception by Markovic that tipped it on to one of his teammates. This is Bogdan Bogdanovic. Serbia almost lost it there. Kalinic, foul was called. It's going to be a Serbia ball. Dump from Hezonja.
Just a great feed. That bounce pass has been employed well by both sides, and he gets it, goes up, and no contact on the play. He's really allowed uncontested to go in and to finish his dunk.
Bogdanovic, no Teja Tosic. Well, Teja Tosic is out there, rather. But Bogdanovic trying to make things happen. And it's Croatia who get the rebound. 3-on-2 if they can work it quickly. Sadic gets it out to Bogdanovic. Closed down. Trying to get in around his opponent. Trying to make space. It's a real physical, tough encounter for both these teams. The foul is called now on Markovic.
He's just trying to draw the attention from the Serbian player. And one-on-one, Bogdanovic was just looking to see if he could back down the Serbian, and he can just step out and then just drop another jump shot. He's getting the flow. He's obviously, with his scoring so far, 16 points. He's got the hot hand for Croatia.
Pass out the back. Now moving to Hezonja, who's cutting inside. Bilan with time to measure, but it's off target. Not the best jump shooter, Bilan. Teodosic laying it off for Markovic. In off the board, gets the foul too. He's going to go to the line for a three-point play. That's what Serbia needed to get fired up.
And they took it, they right to finish it off the play. That's the most important bit of it. Goes right to his bench as well to celebrate afterwards. And you see that it's more than just the shot, isn't it? It's about just getting this team focused and on point. Now he's got the chance for the free throw, and that will bring it within three.
Stefan Markovic has been 100% from the foul line so far at the Olympic Games, and he continues to run to reduce the deficit to three for Serbia. Down by six at halftime. Bogdanovic yet to get going. This is Bilan in the third quarter. Sadic running into trouble. Another turnover. Here's Kalinic trying to get the contact foul finally called. He's going to go to the line for two.
And you just see, as soon as he steals the ball, he's going on his own. He almost has it in his mind that he has to take that ball to the basket. And a couple different channels were being prevented or in their way. But you just see this. It's kind of a wild swing at it from the Croatian defense. And it's going to be an obvious indication of a foul there. And just coming from behind, swatting at it. It's again, it's just one of those flagrant moments that we've seen from both of these teams, just getting a little too activated in the play.
Already three team fouls for Croatia. We haven't even played 3 minutes in this quarter, and it's both shots knocked down to put Serbia within 1 point. Much improved third quarter already for Georgievich's side. Six steals. That's a lot of the defensive pressure coming from the Serbian team, particularly at half court. Now Sadic, it looks like it's for three, but too strong.
It just hits the base of the rim and kicks out, and the quick hands of Serbia getting to it. And what was a margin of 6 points is now back within one. And it's just been better execution, being a little more sensible on the glass, and better movement here overall. The feed into the big man, and they're not going to call a foul on it. He was asking for it. You see as he lost the ball, but they will keep the opportunity with the inbound here. And he's just a player that just needs to just keep it on course. You see him still talking to himself.
Markovic came over just to try and cool things down with Radulica. Stay focused, he said. Now, Bogdanovic in the paint. He doesn't want to be there. Out to Markovic for three. Pulled up short, rebounded by Hezonja.
That's a shot they really needed to take advantage of there. It's still close, but that would have just got him up over the hump and really spurred them on.
Hezonja, good dribbler, but running into trouble there. Does well to recover. Look at the pressure from Radulica. He's just so determined to get the ball. He's going to do anything to get it.
He plays almost like a small power forward in the way that he plays the game, but he's such a big man. And he's a force to be reckoned with, without a doubt, but he's almost a danger to himself and his team just by being overly aggressive.
Another turnover from Serbia. The defense is working well in this third quarter. Radulica! Whoa!
My goodness. Well, he's backed it up, hasn't he, in style. And he has shown that he means business. And you see his teammates coming out to him. And this is a celebration of a moment executed to absolute perfection. And he peaks high up over the rim. There was nothing but a dunk coming from Radulica. And he just devours the defense from Croatia. Said, I don't care who's standing there. It's that orange rim that I'm going to attack with this ball.
Sadic got hit by a freight train named Miroslav Radulica. Timeout called. I think it's needed. It's Croatia 40, Serbia 41.
Ako smo napali s ove strane, prelazi, trčamo za njih. Ostani široko. Ostani široko.
Croatia needed the breather. They've been outscored by Serbia 9-2 in this third quarter. That's all that Croatia have scored in this third term. And that's what Radulica did just before. Sadic was put on the ground. And the dunk was made by Radulica to give Serbia a one-point lead.
You see the flexion in the rim coming off the backboard. And he is much almost just peeled that right off the backboard with the force and the power to emphasize that last shooting score. But they will take it in transition now, Serbia.
Simon missing the shot. Really disappointing for Croatia at the moment. Bogdanovic goes coast to coast and finishes with the layup. It's a three-point lead for Serbia now. They're out shooting Croatia 11-2 in this third quarter.
And he comes around with the left hand, follows up his play, took an angle to the basket, and utilizes his speed, his strength, and his body control. And it's just, as you say, a great run right now for Serbia, 11-2 in this third quarter.
Bogdanovic is going straight through that. Croatian defense was feeling a little bit intimidated after that Radulica slam.
Well, it was the speed of the game, speed of the transition, the quick passing, and you saw really the point being made with Radulica, that slam. He just took it with such conviction and confidence that it does make a statement. It does emphasize to Croatia that you entirely believe that you're in this game and you can win it.
Milan getting things to back within one, getting Croatia back to within one. Markovic. Kalinic does well to speed around Sadic. Great work from Serbia.
It's that first step. He just takes it and he beats his defender and gets underneath that basket, drives right along the baseline and comes around. And they have been consistent in their scoring. They've responded if Croatia have been able to. It's a 13-4 run now in this period.
Sadic is done for the turnover. And I have to take control here. Yeah. That's going to be a technical foul on Sadic for just getting frustration, getting the better of him there. Just pushing his opponent. There's a few scratches on Saric's back, but there's no need for that. No need for that at all.
There is no need, and then equally Jokic just overcooking it, though, too, with the fall. I mean, it becomes a little bit of an ugly one because the frustration will come from the Croatians by seeing the embellishment there from the Serbian. They do get the benefit of the technical foul here, but that's what starts to bring the bite and a little bit of the nastiness that will come into a game. So the refs need to keep this with a short leash on it right now.
Two shots at the line and the possession for Serbia. Unsportsmanlike conduct from Sadic, who I think has just gone off as well. Needs to cool down and regather his composure, as Croatia do right now, because they're down by four and they were up by six at halftime. Quick turnaround from Serbia. Bogdanovic kicking it out to Markovic. Plenty of time for Kalinic. He's missed it. Oh, what a rebound from nowhere, Markovic.
Just steps in and there's bodies around, just not alert or quick enough on the board, Croatia, to respond to that loose ball.
Teodosic for three, too strong. And Kalinic, well, that was over the top. Trying to get the rebound there. I think he was inspired by Markovic's earlier effort.
Well, they are encouraging each other on, and you are seeing it. Almost these individual drives to the basket from Serbia has elevated the whole team's play.
It's an intense battle between these two. We always thought it would be, but for the most part, it's been well played. The game's been played hard but fair. There's been a few fouls.
Well, it has been, and it's been a little bit scrappy in spells, and then you've seen some real prolific shooting. Bogdanovic really the most notable one for Croatia, but he's gone quiet in this third period.
He has indeed, and that's a real concern for the Croatian team, and it's an offensive foul called. It's just not going Croatia's way at present. Bogdanovic has barely had a look. He had 16 points in the first quarter, none so far in the second, or the third, I should say.
And you see the expression on the coach there. That is Petrovic, who went to Bogdanovic at the end of that half of play before they went to the rooms. And he was so excited. And right now, they're feeling a little bit of the air coming out of their balloon because Serbia have just come out of that locker room at halftime. And they're a little bit of a different team in the second half.
Teodosic Finally getting out to Bogdanovic for three. Oh, Serbia, they're on a real roll here. 7-point lead for the side that came second at the World Championships in 2014.
That's now 17-4 for Serbia in this third period. And they've just really just turned this game on its head with sharp shooting, being smart, and just being effective with the ball. They've not been as careless and just a little bit more polished, a little bit more on point, and they've executed their shots. And there's a wonderful example of just how they've stayed on course.
The three from Bogdanovic, everyone contributing for Serbia. 7 points for Marković, 7 points for Radulica, 9 points for Bogdan Bogdanovic. His opposite name, Bojan Bogdanovic, is at the free throw line for two.
Radulica to get the 7 points, and from him, if he can get the double digits, is a good, solid contribution from him. He's been able to keep himself sensible, but needs to be mindful getting into that foul range as well as part of his game. He's been aggressive and just needs to just keep it within his range.
Two shots at the foul line, somewhat stemming the tide for the Croatians, but Serbia look on a roll here. Marković back to Bogdanovic. 5-point lead, and Marković is going to finish this off. A great Serbian move, that extra pass always there.
You look at the scoring, it's been Radulica who's actually at 17 points per game on average, and he's sitting here at the moment with the 7 points only, but it's the balance of scoring, as we've been saying, that Serbia have been able to have. And there's a great outside shot there from Croatia, just keeping this within check.
Didn't Croatia need that triple from Babic? It was a great pass as well from Bogdanovic. Long range three attempt. Oh, brilliant! What a response by Serbia.
And it's a classic case of anything you can do, I can do better, at least as well as. And from range, that was well beyond the 3-point. That was from NBA 3-point range, and he just executes it right off the back of the rim. It's a very comfortable score. He was totally uncontested from there.
Croatia trying to force the pass there with Sadic, asking Babic to get into position earlier, but it's an 8-point lead here for Serbia. What a turnaround in the third quarter. Look at this 3-pointer from Bogdanovic.
He is from downtown and deep to just flush that one from range, the 3-pointer. You see the bench from Serbia. Every single one of the players is up and involved and activated, and each of those players on the floor communicating with them as they score each time. It's all eye contact, it's all unified right now from Serbia in their attack.
They are looking really strong here. Jovic getting into the paint, Jokic rather. Again, it's great passing movements, and then Teodosic, oh, that is magnificent from Teodosic. Fake the shot, gives the pass, easy layup.
So patient. The shot was there and available to him, but the easier play was to go down underneath the basket, and they just tidy up the business and put it on the board.
Oh, and they're doing the defensive work too. 7 assists from Teodosic, and they finish it off after the turnover.
And maybe expecting there was going to be contact there. Jovic, though, stays with it, is patient, and keeps the ball moving forward. He doesn't get fouled in the end. They allow it uncontested, almost to a degree. Croatia not wanting to give further fuel to the fire and give him the extra shot from the line. But this has been a overwhelmingly impressive performance coming out in the second half from Serbia.
They lead by 12 points now with just over 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. The timeout is called. Serbia looking in control. Serbia are outscoring Croatia 26-8 in the third quarter. They've overturned a halftime deficit into a 12-point lead led by Bogdan Bogdanovic with some fantastic 3-point shooting. He's on 12 points for the Serbian side, leading the scoring for them. Croatia need to stem the tide here and try and get themselves back in this contest.
And the key for Serbia not only has been the better shooting, but they have distribution. They've got 8 different shooters in this game, so everybody activated, involved, and that's always going to be more challenging than an isolated great performance from an individual player. Just every single one is on page with what's being asked of them.
It's in contrast to Croatia with Bogdanovic getting 20 points, leading the way for them. Fouls called and the basket. It's all going Serbia's way at the moment.
And there you see Bogdanovic, his obvious frustration. He's seeing a team that's just more impassioned, just better executing. They're sharper, and they're just able to get to the basket with ease. And it's just about being alert. It's about being quick. And it's equally just about being just sharp and effective with their decision-making.
Bogdanovic, who plays for Fenerbahce, but has spent some time in the NBA with the Sacramento Kings and the Phoenix Suns, was a 27th pick overall in the NBA. Going wide with a very strong performance in this third quarter. Foul on Teodosic, a real leader of the team, a fantastic passer of the ball.
He's such a mature player. He was just sensible when there were spells in that first half when Serbia looked to be either a little bit disjointed, maybe a little too emotional. He was just the player that was just marshalling, leading, and making sure that they kept within range.
So it's a 13-point lead for Serbia. Bojan Bogdanovic, it's so easy to get confused right now, but they're both scoring, that's for sure. Bogdanovic at the line for Croatia. Radulica ready to come back on.
And it's been a while for Bogdanovic. He had that overwhelming first half with 16 points, been quite quiet, but he gets on the line and brings it within 11 points. But considering they were up by 6 at the halftime, it's been a long journey back, and it's going to be a long journey from this range.
Going back to that slam dunk from Radulica, 8 assists from Teodosic, the numbers from him are extraordinary every game. But that dunk from Radulica really got things going for Serbia.
It was a turning point. And you talk about his overall offensive output, that he's expected to bring more, but you could see his, probably from his teammates, he's desperately wanted to do well, perform well in this game. And it was just a little bit, it was struggling to get going, but he found a way just to stay with it. And I think it's the battling effort of trying to stay with his game and make sure that he was making a contribution. And it was just emphasized, that slam dunk. He just took it with such conviction and just found a way to will it home.
Serbia looking like they're finding a way here to the semifinals. It's back on the court for them. Always a presence in the paint, providing the screen here for Bogdanovic. Pick and roll move, back out to Kalinic for 3. Oh, it's missed by a long way there. A minute to go in this third term. Mazonia driving, getting into trouble. No foul called. I think it's going to be a Croatia ball from the baseline.
Really interesting to attack the Serbian defense. Just corrals the ball into his body and then tries to elevate here. He's in a line, just hoping to get the foul before the shot had been taken. And they were just a little too patient with Serbia. They didn't reach in and make contact on the arm. And then in the end, just the overwhelming swipe of the ball. And they're just really challenged right now, Croatia, just to get that shooting game going.
Now on Bogdanovic. Daniel Sadic to the line. He's barely been seen in this third quarter. He's only got 5 points so far. This is only his second free throw.
He's been quiet, and he'll need to just use this to just get his game going. And he goes off the front of the rim, and the expression says it all from his coach, Petrovic. Just are wondering if, in fact, they're letting this game slip from their grasp.
Croatia, after doing so well to get into the quarterfinals with that win over Lithuania. And it's 2 misses at the foul line from Sadic. Uncharacteristic here. And it's just not going right for Croatia at present. Kalinic, it is going right for Serbia though. Bogdanovic, Radulica has got 3 players around him. And the foul is called. It's on Ukic there, reaching in, trying to get the ball.
Lukic ended up hitting the deck on the floor. He did reach in. And it was the attempt. There is the big man. You just can't. He's kind of a fascinating watch, isn't he? To see him work the ball. Miroslav Radetica. And he just is the big man. He's at the line now. This isn't necessarily his strength, but he strokes the first one and gets it on the board This is, he's had two from three, so doing not bad in fairness. At 67% in this match. It's not necessarily, well, he's operating at that 76, so he's actually got a pretty decent touch in fairness there to be operating at that level for a big man.
For a big man to shoot like that from the foul line is very encouraging because he'll get a lot of fouls, and getting the high fives at the moment, also important. Roko Okic is now on four personal fouls. One more and he's out of the game. Foul is called here. Luckily for Croatia, it's not on Okic. It seems to be on Bogdan Bogdanovic of Serbia. Just his third personal. 13-point lead for Serbia. They would have taken this coming into the third quarter for sure.
31-12 has been the score line in this third quarter. And a chance for Bogdanovic to just take a bite out of that with the free throw there. He brings it within a dozen. But it's almost too much for a man even of his caliber and the way he's played in this tournament to be expected to be the difference. He's scoring at the rate that he has been able to produce for his team. It's just there hasn't been enough, or equally, I think, to be honest, Serbia have been outstanding to have the balance and depth in scoring right through their lineup.
This is Jovic for Serbia. Bogdanovic, another long-range three attempt. Oh, Bogdanovic. Is dominating from outside.
He's got 18 points, and he has been 3 from 4 from range. And that just stepping, coming off of the pick, rolling up to the top, and just elevating with a beautiful delivery to the basket. And that'll be the last score unless something crazy happens here. But Serbia just propel themselves forward to a 14-point advantage after being back by 6 at halftime. It's been an overwhelming period.
What a third quarter from Serbia. Coming into the final term, Croatia 52, Serbia 66, and frustration has crept in for Croatia. Referees trying to make sure everything stays cool on the benches, but at present, it's Serbia in control, a 14-point lead going into the final quarter. The semi-finals are in sight, but Croatia will come at them in the final term.
And as a look at the shooting, Serbia haven't been necessarily so advantaged in that area, but their three-point game has come to life. It's increased, but you look overall size and make sure his presence was still being felt.
Good work from the referees to calm things down. It's a 14-point lead for Serbia. The fourth quarter in the men's basketball quarterfinal between Croatia and Serbia. 14 points, not an insurmountable score if this Croatian side can get going. There's an early whistle here in the fourth quarter. Hezonja hasn't really fired. I don't think he's scored a three-pointer yet, and that's usually his strength. Bogdanovic, he doesn't want to foul. I think he's on 3 fouls coming into this final term. If that foul, yes, it is indeed on him. 4 fouls for Bogdanovic. That'd be a big blow if he fouls out.
Well, he's right with his back against the wall now. He's been substituted, and Teodosic will come back into the game, their captain. And he's a steady old pair of hands to be having in there, probably just as fine. He's just under 25 minutes of action so far in the game, and get himself just to make sure that the ball is moving in the right channels and being managed in the way it needs to as well for Serbia. With 14 points, it really is a thinking man's game for Serbia. They really, from this position, should be able to come forward and be able to play the game at the pace that they want to play it.
Two players in foul trouble for Serbia, Kalinic and Bogdanovic. Inbound here for Croatia, finds Planinic. Picked up by Simon. He can hit the threes, but Bogdanovic is their go-to player. The shot clock's down. Great pressure from Serbia. He does get the pass out. They have to move quickly. Hezonja for three, and that's just what Croatia need at the start of the fourth quarter.
As you said, he hadn't called his name from three-point range, and then he finally does arrive to the party. And there is a moment of inspiration for Croatia. Be looking at their options. They've got another three-point shooter, and he might just be getting hot.
Hezonja with the three from the corner to start the fourth quarter for the Croatian side. They need him to fire, take some of the pressure off Bogdanovic. Timeout's called. It's an 11-point lead for Serbia.
Okay. Nema nervoza,
So there you see the both the Bogdanović. They are taking care of business offensively for their respective sides, and then the support scoring as well. But what you don't see there on the graphic is the depth right across the board for the Serbians. But this is a shot at the opening stages of this fourth period of play, and maybe a good omen to show that Croatia have a little bit more in which to bring to this particular matchup. It's by no means done at this stage, but they're going to have to get even more, maybe from Bogdanović on the Croatian side. But where else will the support scoring come from?
Here's Marković for Serbia. Teodosic, of course, on. He was thinking he was going to get a rest, then Bogdanović fouled, was into foul trouble, and had to be taken off. But here is those great moves from Serbia. The patient approach, looking for the extra pass. But here, the shot clock's running down on them. Jovic kicks it out to Mačvan finally. Oh, they've done well with the offensive rebound. Marković read it well.
Yeah, they've just been in and around that rim. They get a great sense for how the ball might come off of it, and they've just been sharper, quicker, and equally making their own good luck.
Shot clock was down there, and it's come out Planinic. So 5 seconds on the shot clock with Serbia inbounding from the baseline. They have some set moves from here. They used one in the first possession of the game. Inbounded by Marković, out to Jovic. Goes for the three. Oh, brilliant stuff from Serbia. I don't think they even look at the clock. They just do it.
Jovic felt that one. He steps back and just takes the three-point option and a little bit of the fadeaway, and he's able to put it down. And that type of moment, again, very disheartening for Croatia, trying to find ways to get back in this game. But Serbia are just finding range. And again, from Jovic, from distance. And for Jovic and Jokic in that one, that's his first. So there, another option. And there you see Jovic putting it down. His first from range, and he puts it in the bottom of the basket.
14-point lead now for Serbia. Almost stepping out, but giving it away, Simon. And here comes Serbia on the fast break, fouled by Bogdanović. It's going to be a Serbia ball. Not one of those players into foul trouble. That's his fourth now for Bogdanović. So none left for him either. If he fouls again, Bogdanović is out of the game. Both of them on each side are on four fouls. So important, those players. Shock with a foot violation. Maybe a Serbia ball. How do you play this? Do you keep him on?
Well, they're going to have to push here, aren't they? They have the big spread of 14 points, and then 8 points left in the match. You're going to have to rely on him having enough understanding of the danger, the imminent danger of taking a fifth foul and being out of this game. He's just going to have to find a way, and it's easier said than done, because Serbia are aggressing the play. They've been aggressive in how they've attacked it, and they've put that constant pressure on Bogdanović.
Great stuff from Hezonja. They need a big quarter from him. So far, he's delivering a triple and the two there, reducing the deficit to 12. Taking some of the pressure off Bojan Bogdanović, who has been the outstanding scorer for Croatia. He's the outstanding player for Serbia. Teodosic just running into trouble. You just wonder how tired he might get, because he didn't get the rest he was meant to.
Well, he has to stay the course there. He goes up and is then effectively dropped in this play. But Hezonja has just started to find his groove in this fourth period and taking a little bit of the pressure off Bogdanović. It's a great stop and pop there as he just hits the two spot from a little back step, buys himself a little bit of space over the Serbian defense.
Number 5 pick in the NBA in 2015 for the Orlando Magic, and you can see why. He's a very talented player. Bogdanović, one talented player himself, who goes to the board and gets the two. It's a 10-point game now. This one is still close, despite Serbia's fairly comfortable lead coming into the fourth quarter. Well, it's given away. Touched off a Croatian player last.
And that is the interesting thing about basketball, particularly with the three-point range. If you get a couple hot shooters, what looked like impressive leads where teams should be able to manage it, things in the way this game is being played, because there's that emotional element, that personal element, that real rivalry involved, that things can twist quickly because it's just got a little extra bite to it from both benches. They're just so involved in it.
Simon. Croatia outscoring Serbia 7-3 so far in this term. Sadic. Oh, it had to go in for him. He almost looked like he had messed it up, but then eventually dropped.
He just takes it aggressively, almost looks as like he decided when he was in midair whether he was going to go off the glass or just take the finger roll up over the rim, but he gets the favorable bounce and it does go down, and now we're in single digits as far as the lead. That's outstanding.
Oh, what a player. He looked like he was going nowhere. There's no options. That's okay. I'll just hit a three.
Just stepped in and it was really almost like the player that most will see. There was a foul on his arm there it was. And is it coming in? It's coming in from Saric. But the finish, it could be a 4-point play here. And you see the crossing.
You can't believe it.
Wow, he just knows that he's made his own good luck and he's had a real blessing there. As you saw the way he was thanking and doing his Hail Marys as he's now set to drop a free throw.
For a 4-point play. You don't see many of these at the Olympic Games, but Milos Dedosic has worked for one. And it doesn't count in for him. Well, still, the other important point out of that is that Saric is now on 4 personal fouls as well. The big players from Croatia are in foul trouble. Here's one of them, Bogdanovic, driving through the lane. Jesus, that cannot be an offensive foul or he's in big trouble.
I don't think so. I think he was tracked there by Radulica, and he was staying with them, and he's right on the edge too. Bogdanovic very quick to step in and attack this basket. It's the body making contact from Radulica as he just gets a little too aggressive. You see as well, only too happy was Bogdanovic to just embellish that or just give it a little bit of extra color at the end of it.
He gets the first free throw. He's been very strong from the foul line, 100% for Croatia. And obviously their top scorer now with 27 points. And of course, Radulica also in foul trouble. 4 personal fouls for him. Well, it's a first miss, but it's worked out for Croatia because they've gotten the ball back. They got the rebound there. Simon with the hook shot. Oh, the hook shot of a big man from Simon.
It was impressive coming across the lane on an angle and really against the flow of his momentum. Just drops that in for another 2 points.
Radulica back on for Serbia and staying on despite being on 4 personal fouls. Teodosic loves the bounce pass. And he's got great vision. He's got a great feel for the game. It's just a pleasure to watch.
He is. He's very smooth and silky. And that last 3-point shot that he made almost looked as though he was going to pass it, distribute it, looked as though he was stalled, and then he finds a way. But this is the running hook shot. And that was a great effort from the Croatians there just to keep that. Simone makes that shot. And he's been effective enough. He's just put 4 points on the board in the 16 minutes of work. But there's going to need to be, as well as we say, some more shooting coming from Croatia. They're 8 points adrift.
The turnovers have hurt Croatia, but there was a turnover there from Serbia. It was a travel called. Radulica is going to get a rest. 9 points for him. A solid effort. He's a solid player.
The 30% field goal percentage is not where he has been shooting in his tournament, but he has as well found a way to be effective, been a presence in this game when he has been on the floor. This, again, it's the driving to the basket that is putting pressure on Serbia. And that was Bogdanovic again looking just to press the issue and to take the ball to the basket.
15 foul from Serbia, so Croatia will go to the line for two here. Serbia did concede over 40 free throws against the United States, so they're not afraid to keep fouling and conceding the free throws. It seems to work in their favor because it slows the game down and helps them out. Kamenic at the line for two for Croatia. They've been edging away at this lead, and that's how you have to do it. And now this could put it to within 6.
The most important part is they've got the clock stopped. And they've been able to have a little think and, you know, really collect their thoughts and make sure that they understand the importance of each one of these possessions. And equally, there's been a little bit of a nod here from Bogdanovic that he's going to be more aggressive attacking the basket. There's Saric, who sat on the bench, and there's going to have to be other contributors in this match for Croatia. And they've all got a sense for that, of purpose here in the last 5.5 minutes.
Both teams strong from the foul line. Teodosic, well, that one was read by Babic, who gets things started quickly for Croatia. It's a difficult pass out to Simon, who's done well to gather it and puts up the floater. Simon has got the hot hand for Croatia now.
And the celebrations, look at the scenes on the sidelines. That was Croatia in excitement, of course. They've just inched their way back. 16-6 in this fourth period has been the scoreline for Croatia.
And another turnover from Serbia after the missed basket. They need to stem the tide. Djordjevic is just wants things to stop. He wants this Croatian team to stop scoring. It's 16-6, like you said.
And it's just been, that's an emotional response. He's going to call it to be a timeout. He's not able to employ it. They're going to have a substitution coming in. But Croatia are on a run here right now, and they are going to continue to want to add to it.
Simon, oh, he missed the three there. Looked like he might have gone in for a second. Markovic gets fouled. He's going to go to the line for two because both teams are in foul trouble now. There's been a lot of fouls in this game. And it looks like your three throw shooting is what's going to make the difference.
He would have almost counted on Simon to have made that shot. It was awkward. He was kind of fading away, but he had enough on it to be able to be effective. This is the running shot here that he was able to score just a moment ago that really lit the fire on his bench. But fouls are obviously a huge factor in the closing chapter of this particular matchup. And they've got to be smart and they've got to be effective from this free throw line. It's going to control the remainder of this game.
Markovic is at the line. Both teams have been shooting very well from the line, but no one quite as good as Stefan Markovic, who is 100% in the Olympic Games.
Outstanding shooting from the line, and just shows his mental toughness and his steel just to keep focused.
Oh, that's extraordinary. He's practiced those a fair bit. It's a 6-point lead again for Serbia. 4:50 to play in this game, but Croatia are well in it after being down by quite a margin coming into the fourth quarter.
They were down by as much as 14 points, and now it's brought back within six.
Here's Bogdanovic. Oh, almost lost it in backcourt. He got rid of a Croatian defender by doing so, though. Recovered now, but Hezonja for three! Hezonja knocks down the triple.
And Hezonja has just brought this game into, well, it's totally flip a coin time now as to which way this is going to go. What looked to be certainty of Serbia showing dominance in this ball game, it has changed in this fourth period of play. And it's a different Croatian side now. They are within 3 points of giving themselves a chance to take this further. We may have extra time coming up in this matchup. We've got a sharper shooting team now from Croatia.
Timeout is called. It's Croatia 71, Serbia 74. Emotions are riding high on both benches. Croatia have staged a late rally in the fourth quarter. They're within 3 points. They were down by 14 going into the final term. Hezonja's triple there has made this potentially a one-basket game. Is the momentum now with Croatia?
It's interesting watching the dynamic in that timeout, the respect that Petrovic has for Bogdanovic. He kind of almost just stepped in there and asserted himself, just emphasizing the point that was on the chalkboard that was being discussed. But this is all going to come down to shooting now, and Serbia need to find a way just to get themselves reestablished.
Jokic in the paint, and he's missed it, and these are big misses now. Every possession is crucial with 4 minutes to play and 3 points in it. Babic was talking to the referee while the play was going on.
He was discussing something and just looking for some clarity whether or not there was contact prior off the ball, but they're going to get the inbound coming in from the sideline now. And with exactly 4 minutes to go, with the opportunity, they've got 16 seconds in the shot clock.
The Serbian defense that was so good in that third quarter is being opened up by Croatia now. And some excellent shooting there, but here it is. That brilliant Serbian defense. Bogdanovic in for Jovic. Oh, he's taken too long, and it's lost by Serbia. They can ill afford to lose chances like that.
Well, it was just so aggressive. The Croatians coming back. It didn't end up touching, making contact as he went up to take the shot, and then he decided not to shoot. He looks for the offload. Very curious decision-making there. That type of stuff will haunt you.
Bogdanovic, oh, great offensive rebound by Plenic, who's been fouled, and he'll go to the line for two. It's really tense on the floor and in the stands.
Oh, the crowd is just rolling with the punches here as the teams have gone back and forth, and they've had good spells of being in control of this match, and both sides, well, probably never feeling as though they were going to run away with it, but they have not quit, either side, in believing that they have just as much of a rightful opportunity to go through to that semi-final.
The semi-finals are on the line. Bragging rights in the region are on the line. National pride on the line as well. There's 3 points in it with 3:26 to play. Darko Planinic is on the free throw line to try and make this a 1 point game. Both teams' foul shooting has been very good. And they're coming to this last few minutes. It needs to stay that way if they're going to win it.
Yeah, he's at 100% as well. That's his fifth one that he's been able to put down in the game. And it is going to be entirely that, your ability to make these shots from the line in these closing stages.
Croatia were down by 14 points going into the fourth quarter. They're now down by one. What a finish we have in store in the quarterfinals of Rio 2016. Here's Teodosic. Real thinker in the Serbian team, always makes the right choice, and he's done it again there and finished off with the finger roll by Jokic.
It's an outstanding play. Pulls enough defensive attention towards him, two players looking at him, and then he just releases the big man, and he takes it to the baskets and puts it away. It's Jokic with the score.
Almost lost by Bogdanovic. It was recovered by Planinic, who provides the screen. Difficult pass for Simon. Did well to bring it down. Foul called, and Simon, and that's on Bogdanovic. Bogdanovic is out of the game.
You can see the expression on his face. He knows that it was a quick first step that ends up putting him on the bench for the remainder of this one. And he's frustrated, but he's done good work. He's going to just have to accept it there. It's the job for him has been done with 18 points and just the one shot as well. He was 3 from 4 from three-point range, and they're going to sorely miss him in the remainder of this match.
Seemed like there wasn't anything in it. He would have been better off. It was hard to get out of the way, really. Simon at the line, gets the first. Lots of players in foul trouble, though. Not just Bogdanovic, Sadic, Ukic, Bojan Bogdanovic for Serbia, Radulica, Kalinic, and Bogdanovic already fouled out. Simon, 2 from 2 at the line. It's a 1 point game again, 2:50 to play. We are in for something very special in these last few minutes. It could go either way. It's been a seesawing battle, both teams winning quarters, but it's the last one that's going to count most. Markovic, long range three attempt, too strong. The determination to get the offensive rebound, and look at that, it falls to Bojan Bogdanovic.
Croatia just smart enough just not to get into those battles when you had some quick assertion from Serbia trying to get to that rebound. They just find a way to just come out of it cleanly.
Zonja, it doesn't drop for him. And the offensive foul, or the foul called, actually trying to get the offensive rebound, Croatia. I think it'll be a Serbia ball here.
And you get a sense that if Croatia are able to take the lead right now, that they've lost a little bit of their belief have Serbia to have been up so much and now to have been pegged back within one. This could be a mental mountain that'll be difficult for them to overcome. This is precious possession for Serbia on this inbound.
Radulica, now come in another foul. Just checking that was the case, I think. Such a solid player, so important for Serbia in the paint. 2:14 to play, a 1 point lead for Serbia. It was a close one when they last met in major competition in 2010, one that Serbia won. But this is going down to the wire once more in the Olympic Games. Teodosic. getting it in for Radulica, and in off the board. So important for Serbia to get baskets now because they're being outscored 23-10 in the final quarter.
Such a sensible finish from Radulica to take that, put that, feel the pressure from the body, and then go up with the left hand.
Simon for three, bounces out. Great offensive rebound by Planinic. Pressure coming. They're all over him. No foul called. Croatia ball.
And that really was a fortunate moment for Serbia. Two players on Planinic. Nothing called. The referee right there, giving it a little bit more rope inside the closing 2 minutes.
Simonovic has plenty of fouls left, so he doesn't mind. Sadic is off right now, of course, on four personal fouls himself. Oh, come on for the last. Bogdanovic for three here. Pulled up short. Difficult shot. The clock was running down on him as well. Less movement now. Players are getting tired. Teodosic, both teams have gone about the same from three-point land. Teodosic for Serbia. Markovic thought about the three, gives it to Teodosic, who does go for three, off target. Offensive rebound's important, but it's Croatia who pick it up. Still a three-point lead for Serbia. This is going to be an incredible finish. Coming to the last minute of the game, Bogdanovic driving, he's lost it, and it's gone out. It'll be a Croatia ball. Every move from the referee is so important.
Well, he lost this ball early in his first couple steps, and then he tried to finish it off with steps 3, 4, and 5, and trying to get the attention of the referee, and they don't. They hold on to the whistle, don't give anything. It was just actually a pretty clever move there by the big man. And Radulica just comes in and just quietly just picks the pocket, but as he picked up a foul on the play,
it looked like he got his fingertips to the foul. If the foul was called, they would have gone to the line for two, surely.
Yeah.
So they're just taking him off. Too close. Georgievich doesn't want to risk it anymore. Babic for Croatia. Of course, it could go to overtime as well. Three-point lead for Serbia at present. That's a long-range pass. Shot clock's running down. It's going to run out for Croatia. Brilliant defensive play by Serbia. Did Croatia lose sight of the clock there? They seem surprised.
Well, they just equally, I think Babic had his foot on the line as well, and that's just sloppy execution, just not paying attention to the shot clock and being aware of when it needed to be released. And this is a valuable, again, possession that's going to come on an inbound. And there he is. He's back in the game, Radulica. And he's going to be a player you expect that Serbia are going to try to get the ball to and see if he can't just control some of this low possession in the zone offensively and maximize the usage of the clock.
One timeout still to go for each team. Serbia going to soak up as many seconds as they can here. They're the ones in control. Teodosic kicks it out to Kalinic for three. Difficult attempt there, but a foul is called on Bilan. Oh, what a moment that could be. It looked like Serbia had lost the opportunity. I think Georgievic is surprised.
I think they got on the backside of each other. Bilan was battling in front with Radulica, and he ended up getting in the wrong side of the ball. The ball goes off the rim. You'll see this between the big man. He just grabs him on the shoulder and just trying to fight. It was Radulica trying to get there for the offensive rebound. He was being restrained, and the referees are right on it, and they let the big man go to the line.
Just to make it a two-basket game. Oh, so close, but he hasn't done it. He's going to have another chance to make it a two-basket game with 27 seconds to go. It's a three-point lead for Serbia. Radulica at the line. The pressure shot makes it.
It's a huge, that's all the difference. And it's not, it's still just be a one-possession game, but from three-point range, nobody you expect from Serbia is going to be putting a hand on any of the shooters. And not that they're going to want to allow a three-point shot to come against anyhow, because I'm sure they're going to be getting that shot off quickly here, Croatia. But it's just all about smarts now. And who would have thought it at the point of this game? After three periods of play, the advantage, it was a 14-point advantage. And now the 10-point scoring, the advantage here in the fourth period. Croatia have brought it within four, and it's really been, it hasn't been a game of two halves. It's probably been a game of about of three or four. It's had too many twists in the storyline today.
Might be still a twist to come, but at the moment it's going Serbia's way. They got a four-point lead with 27 seconds to go. Some brilliant assists from Teodosic. It's almost too many to count, but it is 10 double digits in assists for Teodosic. Seems like he should have more from all the passes he's created.
Well, I can't think of a time in watching him today that he's been sloppy with the ball. He's been careful, he's been measured, and equally, he's been able to make things happen when it didn't look as though there was an opportunity for Serbia. He's created openings for all of his teammates, and when you look at the depth of scoring across the entire lineup, you need an architect, you need a leader in that position, and he's entirely provided that today for Serbia.
27 seconds left. Croatia needs to score here. They've got the foul. That will send Hezonja to the line for two. There's no Shaquille O'Neal you can target to take to the line, so he can miss a couple, because all these Croatian shooters have been very good from the foul line. Seems to be on Kalinic, who takes a seat. He's actually fouled out. A lot of players are treading that line. Hezonja at the line. Just goes in. Jeez, your heart must be beating at a million miles an hour right now.
Just great fundamentals, though, the free throw shooting for the big men, equally of these European players, that they know the importance of the free throw and they execute it and they pay attention to these small areas of the game. And you reference a player that was just so iconic in Shaquille O'Neal, that you could get into the hack a shack at the end of the game and put him on the line. And it became a little bit of a blemish in what was an incredible career for Shaquille O'Neal, just not being able to hit those free throws consistently.
Well, they put Markovic at the line. This is clever play by Serbia, because they knew the foul was coming to stop the clock. That's their best free throw shooter. That's who they gave the ball to. And that's who Croatia fouled. But this is real pressure now. He's 100% so far in all the Olympic Games. And he's missed there. What a time to miss. He's got another chance to make it a three-point lead for Serbia. 23.6 seconds to go. Gets it.
And it's still a one-possession game. Where will they look to?
Hezonja is certainly a candidate, and he's fouled. It's going to be two shots at the line, and that might suit Serbia, because Croatia can't get three then. Simonovic is the player who committed the foul. Bogdanovic is coming off. You must think he's fouled out for some reason. Not sure why Bogdanovic would come off there. But Hezonja is at the line for two. It seems so cool, Hezonja.
He's hit that first one. And they're going to need to foul quickly, our Croatia, to get this potential possession back. They'll come up quickly. And into the capable hands, it will be Teja Dosic, who will go to the line.
It's almost just a three-throw shootout now. Yes. It's whoever gets their three throws is going to win this game.
It's so often the case. You see it certainly in the National Basketball Association, that really into that last 5 minutes of play. So Bilan has now fouled out.
Ukic, rather. I think that graphic may have been wrong. Ukic is the player who was on the foul trouble and committed that foul. That's why he's off. Dosic knocks down the first one. What a leader. What a composed figure. He's been here. It's fine. Don't worry. I've got this. Brilliant from Dosic under pressure. It's a three-point lead from Serbia. And they're not going to foul here. They're going to force Croatia to make the three-point shot. No, Dosic does foul to send Babic to the line. And they're calling a technical. That would be huge, because that would give Croatia the ball back as well and a chance to possibly win the game. They're saying intentional foul by Teja Dosic.
It's an aggressive call. If in fact, that is going to be what has been called from referees. A lot of discussion, as we've seen, amongst the players, with the referees and with the coaches. And that's what Petrovic is appealing for, the suggestion that it was the intentional foul and that it maybe deserves to. I think he's a little bit hopeful there, a little bit searching for something to hang on to, and it's still going on, this discussion on the sidelines.
Should mention that Bilal did foul out. Ukic is on four, and that's a big miss from Babic. It's a three-point game again between Croatia and Serbia. 13.6 seconds to play. What a precious shot this is for Luka Babic.
Now, they practice these shots thousands of times, but nothing can simulate the pressure of this moment.
gets it. Two-point game now. Croatia will want to foul Serbia to take them to the line. It's going to be Jokic. And the free throw shootout continues.
13.1 available. And you're just going to see the quick fouling that's going to be coming in. And then equally, it's all going to be with the execution from the line.
67% from the foul line. You can claim that that one was intentional and should be the ball back as well. Every foul so far in the last 20 seconds has been intentional. So a bit tough on Ter Dosic if you were to call him on it. Here's Jokic. He's got it. And a chance to make it a two-basket game. And that would be huge for Serbia. And Djordjevic is telling him no more fouls. Just let with 4 points, we can allow the three to happen.
Now they need this basket as well, just to give him that breathing space.
He's got it. And what a position Serbia's in now. 13 seconds. Croatia need the three and the ball back, or at least the basket and the ball back. Foul by Ter Dosic. Well, it seemed as though Djordjevic was telling them not to foul. Ter Dosic has taken it upon himself to do just that.
That's a curious decision. You see the discussion going on between the teammates. And he makes the foul before he's gone up for the basket. Ter Dosic is now coming out of the game. And he's fouled out. And so it was a curious decision. Not entirely sure why he made that one. But it's left an opening here now for Croatia. They hit two from a line here and then foul quickly. This is what pressure does.
Azonja, he's 21. He's not feeling any pressure. Extraordinary. Three-point game again. Ter Dosic has fouled out for Serbia. That's a big blow for them. A great performance from Azonja, particularly in this final quarter. Two from two. Now Serbia with the inbound. I think they want to give it to Marković. Jokic is fouled, and he's going to go to the line. These 10 seconds are taking an eternity.
Less than 4 seconds came off the clock there. Petrovic is appealing, suggesting the contact on the arm, but Azonja, he's the Iceman, to have just hit both of those shots and then immediately the pressure. And now the shot's going to come in from Serbia. And this, as you see, a little bit of a different body language at the line here now.
For Jokic, he got his last two pressure shots. And is perfect there. Chance to make it a two-basket game, and we'll see if they foul after this. You'd think they won't. Djordjevic is explaining to Ter Dosic why he didn't want it before. He's got it. And what a position Serbia are in now. Croatia have to work quickly. Azonja for three. Long-range attempt. He's missed it. Croatia get the offensive rebound. Bogdanović is fouled by Marković. Everyone's calling intentional.
And I wonder whether or not Bogdanović is equally not overcooked this as well. It's tough to tell from our position to have seen there, but he's up there fine, but that was pretty heavy-handed. And it's looking for any sort of opportunity. Let's watch this again.
Intense finish, what a rebound too. Oh, geez, that was difficult to see if there was any contact from Nedović.
And if there was, it was certainly lower.
Marković was there too.
Well, maybe he gets a slight touch of his face there, which is just a very curious decision. And both teams just not managing it well these last stages of the game.
To keep Croatia in it, he's got the first one. So at least it's a one-basket game, but they need to get the ball back. This to make it a two-point game with 2 seconds left. But it's really difficult for Croatia from here. Leon Bogdanović. I think he intentionally tried to miss there.
Yep. And they were looking.
And that is it. The buzzer has gone. Serbia are through to the semi-finals. They've held on. What an incredible performance. Radulica has been very strong for them. Bojan Bogdanović got 28 points, but he is bowing out of the Olympic Games. Croatia are out. Serbia through to the semi-finals.
It's a devastating loss. And Bogdanović, it's exactly what he tried to do there at the end of the game. Play it off of the rim, and you see the discussion going on from players who will well know each other, but that's the final result. With Serbia, 86-83, winning over Croatia. They go through to the semifinal.
It was tense, it was tough, it was aggressive. We expected all of that. It was a fascinating game of basketball as well. And in the end, it came down to free throw shooting, and Serbia just took the edge. But Croatia put up a real spirited fourth quarter performance.
Oh, did they ever? And they stayed with it when they were 14 points adrift. You could have, well, at no point would you ever thought they would have mailed it in or just checked their bags. They were going to fight right to the end, and hence the decision that was made there to try and put it off the rim at the end for Bogdanović. That was all about just being game savvy and trying to maximize getting an offensive rebound. But you see what it means. It's not only their best opportunity here now to get onto a medal podium as well, but to beat your dreaded rivals and to have done that here on the Olympic stage. It's a magnificent moment for Serbia.
They made the final of Atlanta 96 as part of the Yugoslavia team. Of course, they won gold as part of the Yugoslavia team, but this is the first time Serbia has made the final four of the Olympic Games. They came second at the World Championships in 2014, and who's to say they won't repeat that feat? But it's an incredible performance from Bogdanović. Teja Dosic was magnificent, as he's been throughout the Olympic Games.
Well, he was seamless, and he was calm. It was curious that he made the decision to foul at the end and not really understanding that the decision was to allow Croatia to go and advance and to score the basket, that they were going to be able to play the game clock out. But, you know, that was the game just seemed to be played at such a pace that some of the decision-making was not only as a result of the pressure, but just the speed of having to make the right call at the right time. But they just had enough of a team game about the way the Serbians attacked the basket, the way they support each other, and their energy throughout their entire lineup was stronger.
And in the end, shooting wasn't the best from both sides. Three throws made the difference, 20 for Serbia out of 25, 80%, just that 1% in it.